Well, now to some disappointing financial news. Superfunds are predicted to deliver their worst return since 2008.
To explain more, we're joined by the Motley Fool's Chief Investment Officer, Scott Phillips. Scott, good morning. But is it actually a good morning? Because we're expecting the worst return since the GFC. Tell us why.
Michael, Christine, good morning. Tell you what, I get the tough job, don't I? I'm not playing beach volleyball. I've got to give you the bad news about Super anyway. But that's life. Hopefully next year we'll get some good news. The challenge, of course, is the same issue that is hurting the economy across the board. It's inflation, which then has precipitated higher interest rates. Now, the finance maths, I'm not going to bore you with it at this time of the morning. Basically, the higher interest rates are, the lower asset prices tend to be. Now, the biggest assets in most super funds are Australian shares, international shares, and residential unlisted property. Add all those things together, that's a pretty tough quartet of downward pressure on super funds, unfortunately, this financial year.
So last year, though, we had quite a strong return rate. So is this significant drop quite surprising?
Look, probably not, because we knew rates were going to up at some point. I mean, if anything, the house price growth, we've talked about this so many times over the last 12 months. In 2021, house prices were up by a quarter and listed property the same. Shares did really well. So to some degree, it's something of a coming back to normality as rates continue to increase. It's not welcome, of course, but it's not surprising either. And over the long term, we do know the share market, for example, has one down year in every three on average. So occasionally we're going to have years like this. Unfortunately, with property and shares going in the same direction and by a big margin, that's why, as you've already said, we're having the worst year since the GFC.
Looking ahead, 2023, are we going to see potentially some better returns?
Fingers crossed, you know. I'm really hopeful. Look, here's the thing. We've seen most of the pain, I think, from higher rates already now in property prices and share price in particular. Now, I do think the RBA will keep raising rates next year. For how long and how high is an open question, depends how inflation responds. In all probability, though, the market's factored in most of that already, or should have factored most of that in. Doesn't mean it won't be volatile, but I've got my fingers crossed for a much better year in 2023.
Yeah,